Hello everyone, it's Leo and it's Peggy time, or should I say Josephine time, because we are going to talk about episode 25 from Healing Good Precure. This was a sidetrack from Asumi's arc that we've been having lately. We finally have something different. And for that, they decided to go with Pegitan, which is a great choice, by the way, since both Rabinin and Nyatoran already had their own episodes, and Pegitan's time was long overdue, and I'm super happy that he finally had his own. And this episode was very, very different from everything we've had so far in Healing Good, and it didn't feel like I was watching a Healing Good Precure episode. It didn't feel like I was watching a Precure episode because it was so different. I mean, this episode was like 95% Pegitan only. And that was very shocking, but also interesting, you know, the way they shifted the narrative a little bit and barely showed the other girls and the other mascots. It was very focused on Pegitan. And from one side, I liked it because I love Pegitan. And from another side, I really wanted an episode in which we would have more interaction between Pegitan and Chiyu. Because in Rabinin's episode, which was episode 15, we had a lot of interaction between Rabinin and Nodoka. And in Nyatoran's episode, which was episode 18, there was a lot of interaction between Nyatoran and Hinata. So now in this one, I was really expecting more Chiyu moments, but we didn't have it. We had like Josephine all the time. But anyways, let's talk about it. The first thing, that first scene with the movie, it was actually a dorama based on what Shindohine said, but it was a kind of like an American series, like a terror series or something. And they were watching it and Pegitan was super scared, but I really loved the style that they went for in that. This episode was really well done. It was really well drawn. And that scene was very, very interesting. The way it was drawn and everything, and I think it was like something from the United States, because one of the characters called the other Jennifer, and okay, I was like, okay, this is probably a United States series or something, and very interesting the way they drew them. I loved it. And then we had a scene that Pegitan imagined him and Chiyu in that scenario again. And I found it very interesting that Pegitan doesn't like being called cute, and he wants to be seen as courageous and brave. He doesn't like this cute title that he has, but it's the biggest part of his personality, and that's what sets him apart from everything. And I really thought that that was the direction they were gonna go for in this episode, in like saying that it's okay being cute, and it's okay not being the bravest and the fiercest one. But they didn't go there. Actually, I don't think that they went anywhere with an argument specifically. But Pegitan was a little frustrated. He needed time for himself, and then he went out, and the girl found him and took him home. Thought he was a stuffed animal, but then Pegitan started playing as he was a real penguin. And the girl gave him this Josephine name. She perked him up, and she was, you know, feeling her fantasy of having a friend, because she was very lonely. We could see that. When her mom came back from work and her food was ready, but the girl was already sleeping. And then when the girl wakes up, the mom was already gone and the girl was very lonely. We could see that Didi was very lonely. Didi is a very triggering name because it's Rihanna's nickname. And Rihanna, where is the new music? When are you gonna come back to releasing new music? Anyways, focus. And so the girls were all very worried about Pegitan, and you know, they were searching for Pegitan. The scenes that they were searching for Pegitan were amazing, and Detective Latte was also great. But those scenes were very quick, very, very quick. We could see that Chiyu was very distressed, she was very sad and worried, and the other girls were all helping her. And then Pegitan was able to escape, but when Pegitan escaped, he decided to check on Didi first, and when he did, he saw that she was very lonely in her class, and he got captured, and you know, that was the trigger for her to be brave and courageous and do something, you know, take action and attitude in something in her life. And by that, she started making friends, you know. So Pegitan was worried about her. Pegitan got bonded with her somehow, and that was cute, actually. I liked it. it was cute showing how Peggy Tan was worried about her, and also interesting. I feel like it's not really character development, I feel like, but it's more like making it clear to us the characteristics that the character has. And we know that Peggy Tan is not brave and he's always scared of doing things, but even though he is like that, he was able to find his partner, he's able to fight with her, he's able to connect with Chiyu very well. They believe in each other, and that's very nice. So we see Peggy Tan saying that he feels like Didi is very much like him, because she is very afraid of doing things and saying things and interacting with people. You know, she wants friends, but she can't interact with people, and that's scary. And I got that, because when I was a child, I was just like that. After a couple of years, I became like that. And it was nice seeing that in Peggy Tan, you know, Peggy Tan looking at her and saying, I'm just like that, so I understand it, let me help her. And he did. But then the girls found it, and then Didi went running away with Peggy Tan. She didn't want to leave Peggy Tan, because Peggy Tan was her only, Josephine was her only friend, basically. And now she was making more friends. She was, you know, her life was changing a little bit, but still, Josephine was her safe space. And so she didn't want to let go, and so she ran away, and then at the same time, the monster appeared. So we had Shindo Inie attacking in this episode. Every time we have a Chiyu episode, Shindo Inie attacks, that makes me wonder if we're going to have a showdown between Shindo Inie and Cure Fontaine at the end of the season. Maybe, I hope so. And before that, we see a scene that was very funny between Shindo Inie and Gwayeru. They were both watching the same dorama that Chiyu and Peggy Tan were watching, but Gwayeru was like the antenna, and she imagining Gwayeru as an antenna girl. I loved it so much. Gwayeru was so big in this episode, his arms, girl. Oh my god, Gwayeru, you kill me. But then Shindo Inie attacked, and Shindo Inie does not have those crystals, and she's not harvesting those crystals either, so she didn't buff this monster. So, you know, we had a very beautiful moment between Peggy Tan and Didi. Peggy Tan opened his heart for her, and he was brave enough to jump and escape from those Dobermans as well. I loved that moment. And he was able to find Chiyu, and they just went on to the fight. So, two things to consider here. First, this is the first episode we don't see Cure Earth's transformation, apart from the others. In this episode, she was bonded together with the other two. And then we had Cure Fontaine's solo transformation. Nice! I love this. And the second one, when Peggy Tan found Chiyu, I thought they were going to have like a big reconciling moment. They didn't. And I understand they did have to fight. They needed to fight the monster. And I was waiting for this reconciling moment between both of them, but we didn't have that in this episode. That was the most frustrating part. Not reconciling, actually, because they weren't in bad terms. But you know, a beautiful moment of them reuniting. And we didn't have that, unfortunately. But the fight. The fight was definitely the worst part of this, because it made absolutely no sense. So first thing, this was a regular Mega Byogen. It wasn't a powered-up Mega Byogen. So Cure Earth could just exist in front of the monster would already be defeated. But no. Cure Earth didn't do anything. She was just escaping, and she even said that if they escaped a lot, they would be tired, and they wouldn't be able to fight against the monsters. It was like, girl, I understand. We needed a little Cure Fontaine moment there, but come on, write it better. Write it better. It made no sense whatsoever. Even without Cure Earth, I mean, Cure Sparkle and Cure Grace could go head on against that monster. We know that. It made no sense. And then Fontaine arrived, and Fontaine kicked the monster, and she defeated it. It was nice, because it's been such a long time since we saw Healing Stream, so her solo attack. So I really liked it. I really liked seeing that again. But the fight, again, no sense whatsoever. Oh my god. Come on. You can do better than this. You can do better than this. But, you know, and then the episode was over. We could see that Chiyu and Peggy Tan went to visit Didi. So Peggy Tan really connected with Didi in this episode, and, you know, a new friend. Cute. A new friend. And then next episode, we're gonna have Asumi being crazy again, wanting to write a diary about Latte and the girls avoiding her. Even Latte doesn't seem to want to play with that. And oh my god, I just cannot wait. You know, that episode is going to be a lot of fun for sure. Anyways, that was my view on episode 25. Please leave a comment with yours. Let's keep talking in the comment box below. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time. Bye-bye!